Hi, this is Eric Ludy. If you happen to be seeing this in the first couple weeks of March, then you can actually enter to win one of our 12 full-ride scholarships that we're giving away for the summer and fall training season at Ellerslie. Go to Ellerslie.com to learn more. This series is entitled Eric Ludy Wrestles with Five Magnificent Men. Do you guys remember Jacob when he grabbed a hold of God and wrestled? And he said, God, I'm not letting you go until I get what you have. Well, that's sort of what this series is about. You see, I'm going to grab a hold of five different men and I'm going to wrestle them because they have something that I want. Now, the five particular men that I'm choosing are sort of odd. Okay, I'm even going to admit that up front. And they're not the full package of what I want, but they represent something. It's almost like God has used them in my life and pointed to them and said, hey, Eric, do you see that? You see that quality? I'm like, yeah. You need to go after that. See, that's a quality that I have. And they just happen to be tugging it around. And in their imperfect way, they did. And so I'm going to grab a hold of these men and I'm going to wrestle for that quality that they have uniquely portrayed in their life that I know that God wants me to have in mind. I hope you enjoy. George Washington is one of my heroes, but that's not what we're talking about here. George Washington Carver. I love George Washington Carver, such an intriguing man in history. And he's not from the mold of the rugged and the robust. You know, he's not going to be the Theodore Roosevelt, the William Wallace, the George Washington. He's more of the softer side. He's more like the Fred Rogers type of model I talked about in an earlier episode. But I have been so attracted to something in this man's life. You see, it wasn't his muscle and it wasn't his deep bassy voice. He had a high-pitched voice, and it's not, yeah, no, that's not what I'm after, you know, necessarily. If I could tune my voice, it might not be to George Washington Carver's voice, but I want his faith. This man had a childlike faith. Doesn't matter how old he got, he had such a simple relationship with God where he believed God could do anything. And after the Civil War, when his people are really struggling, they're emancipated by Lincoln, but they don't know how to do things but grow cotton. So he takes it upon himself, like, God, give me the ability to help my people. And so he discovers the peanut, and he knows that inside this peanut is hope, because it will replenish the soil, whereas cotton was taken from the soil. So he says, God, why did you create the peanut? Help me understand this little thing. And out of it comes hundreds of inventions. I mean, it's truly a remarkable story. If you haven't studied George Washington Carver, I highly encourage it. It is deeply moving. But what I want to grab a hold of George Washington Carver and get from him, yes, it's his gentleness. Yes, it's his compassion and his kindness, because he really was that. But it's specifically his childlike faith. I want that from George Washington Carver. Ellerslie Discipleship Training is all about going after the fullness of Jesus Christ. So we do a lot of wrestling here in Windsor, Colorado. If you've seen Jesus, you've seen his cross, and you recognize you're leaving something behind and you need to go after it, well, why don't you consider joining us for a season here in Windsor, and let's wrestle to get the fullness of Jesus together. Remember, if you're seeing this in the first couple weeks of March, you still may have an opportunity to enter and win one of our 12 full-ride scholarships that we're giving away for the summer and fall training season in 2020. Go to Ellerslie.com to learn more.